Microcontrollers have become more and more powerful over the years, nowadays typically having 32-bit processors running at hundreds of megahertz and capable of having megabytes of flash memory and PS RAM. When we launched our Pro Micro RP2350, this inspired me to do a demo where I ran a thresholding algorithm on a high-resolution image from a camera. It worked great, though it was very bottlenecked by the SPI and USB interfaces. When we launched the Thing Plus RP2350, I removed the bottlenecks with a better camera and display, however the wiring was quite difficult and there wasn't a whole lot you could do with it. We want to make computer vision on microcontrollers easy and practical, so we're launching a new line of products called Red Vision, which begins with the Red Vision Kit for XRP. This kit consists of one touch display board and one camera board, both of which can be purchased individually if desired. When you purchase the kit, both boards come with headers pre-soldered, so you can simply slot them straight into an XRP control board. It uses the same footprint and pinout as a Raspberry Pi Pico, so it should be possible to connect with any footprint-compatible boards. Both boards are also breadboard compatible, so you could connect to other boards by adding jumper wires. The display board also includes a microSD card slot for easy storage expansion, a quick connector for compatible I2C devices, and a reset button. So that's the hardware. It's flexible and easy to use. As for the software, we have ported OpenCV to MicroPython. We go into more detail about it in our other video that you can watch to learn more, but if you're not familiar with OpenCV, it's an extremely popular open source computer vision library with loads of algorithms that you can chain together to create vision pipelines to extract useful data out of images. Combined with the new Red Vision Kit, this opens up brand new capabilities for your XRP. For example, here I have my XRP robot, which uses the same RP2350 microcontroller as a Raspberry Pi Pico 2. I will attach the new Red Vision Kit, and I'll get the headers lined up here, and then I will power on the robot so it can start initializing. I also have this orange ring here that I want my robot to grab, which I'll put in a randomized location. Let's go to the left side. When I push the user button, my code takes an image from the camera and runs an OpenCV algorithm that detects the ring in under 1 second. It then computes the location of the ring in real-world units and shows an annotated image on the display. If I press the button again, the robot drives to the ring and uses the servo arm to pull it off the hook using the location computed from the image. The touch display is also useful by itself. For example, this demo creates a touchscreen user interface that can be used to drive the XRP around. And this demo loads up a sequence of images that creates an animation. Maybe you make an animated face to give your XRP more character. If you do get a Red Vision Kit for your XRP, here's some information on how to get started. Before doing anything with the hardware, it's important to note that you'll need to install different firmware onto your XRP to use the Red Vision Kit. This is currently a manual process, but if we do come out with a more automated process, we'll put some updated instructions in the description of this video. Also be aware that this will overwrite all files on your XRP, so if you have any important files on there, be sure to back them up before you do this. As of right now, the firmware can be downloaded from GitHub. Go to our fork of MicroPython, then the Releases tab on the right side, and within the latest release, expand the assets to find the Red Vision MicroPython XRP UF2 file. Click to download it. To flash the firmware to the XRP, connect it to your computer over USB, then hold the boot button, press and release the reset button, then release the boot button. It should automatically reconnect as a USB mass storage device, and then you can simply drag and drop the UF2 file to it to start flashing. Note that this will take a lot longer than normal MicroPython firmware updates, at least a minute or so, so do be patient. Now let's attach the Red Vision boards. The two rows of 20 male header pins on the bottom of the display board insert into the inner two rows of 20 female header pins on the XRP control board. If these pins are misaligned, it is possible to permanently break the display, so first turn off power and unplug from USB. Ensure that the USB symbol on the bottom of the display board is above the actual USB connector on the control board, then insert it. If you have servos plugged in, you may need to nudge the connector away slightly. It's a tight fit. Once done, look closely to verify that it went into both inner rows and that it's flush front to back. With that done, we can insert the 2x9 male header on the camera board into the 2x10 female header on the display board. Yes, the 2x9 header goes into the 2x10 header. There are other camera boards on the market that use the same 2x9 header, but some use 2x10 headers with the last two pins duplicated. So the display board has a 2x10 header for electrical compatibility with both, and the pinout is marked on the silkscreen. This means that for cameras with a 2x9 header, it needs to be right justified when viewed from above. Also verify that both rows of headers are inserted, not up or down by one. If you want to insert a microSD card into the slot on the display board, you'll first need to format it as a FAT32 file system if it's not already. You can preload it with any files you want, then insert it into the slot on the bottom of the display board. Because it's on the bottom, the microSD card needs to be upside down with the pins facing up. Note that the board uses GPIO 7 for the chip select pin of the microSD card, which is the same pin that's used for the Servo 3 header. So if you're using a microSD card, you won't be able to use Servo 3. Once you've connected everything and verified that the pins are all aligned correctly, you can power up the board and you should see LEDs on both the display and camera boards and the XRP control board. With all that done, you're ready to start using the Red Vision Kit. go ahead and connect your XRP to your computer with a USB cable. Then open a browser and navigate to xrpcode.wpi.edu. As of filming, XRP code may prompt you to update your MicroPython firmware, but don't do it. We just flashed the Red Vision firmware, and XRP code doesn't really know what it is yet, so ignore that. If XRP code prompts you to update the XRP library files, allow it to do so. This will install XRP lib needed to control things like the actuators, get data from sensors, and so on. Once that finishes, you'll see the same XRP examples and lib folder as normal XRP, but you'll also see this Red Vision examples folder, which contains a number of examples demonstrating how to use the Red Vision board with OpenCV. It's best to run through the first few examples in order to verify that your hardware is working correctly. You can read the comments in the examples and watch our other video on OpenCV and MicroPython to learn more, but I'll run through a couple examples to show you what you should expect. Example 1 can be used to verify that the display is working. Double-click the file to open it, then click the Run button in the top corner. After a moment, you should see the display initialize, show the Red Vision splash screen for a moment, then show an image that was created with OpenCV's drawing functions. If so, then your display and OpenCV are both working. This example is not quite done yet. Most of the Red Vision examples wait for input from the REPL at the bottom using the OpenCV wait key function. Click down in this window, then press any key on your keyboard to finish the example. This first example prints whatever key was pressed to demonstrate that you can acquire the keyboard input to do something with that. So you can use this as an alternative to the stop button in the top corner, though that should work fine too. Example 2 can be used to verify that the camera is working. Again, double-click to open, then click the Run button in the top corner. After a moment, you should see the live camera view on the display, which means your camera is working as well. With this camera and display, you only get around 5 or 6 frames per second because there's some color space conversions happening behind the scenes. You may also notice that the image has a green hue to it, which is because this camera module outputs a raw Bayer image. The driver does de-Bayer or de-mosaic the image, but no color grading is done like webcams, so it results in a somewhat green image. There's also a fairly strong vignette effect from the lens, making the image darker at the edges. So the image quality is admittedly not the best, but the trade-off is that this camera requires dramatically fewer GPIO pins than other cameras. You can use a camera with a better image quality, but it will need many more GPIO pins, so you'll lose access to some of the XRP features like motor 3 and 4. We'll talk a little more about that later in this video, and also note that we have not yet implemented drivers for other cameras. To finish, click the stop button or press any key in the REPL at the bottom. You can run through the rest of the examples to verify that everything else is working and see some of the features of Red Vision in OpenCV. If you want to learn more about OpenCV, there are lots of resources and tutorials online. Just keep in mind there are some minor differences with the MicroPython port of OpenCV, and not all OpenCV features are implemented in MicroPython. For those wanting to learn more about these new Red Vision boards, here are the specs and details. First is the Red Vision touch display for Pico. The primary component is a 320 by 240 resolution touchscreen display. It's based on the very popular ST7789 display driver with an SPI interface, and it uses the CST816 touchscreen driver with an I2C interface. The headers on the bottom have the same footprint as the Raspberry Pi Pico, so it should be compatible with any other boards using the same footprint. It's also breadboard compatible if you prefer to use it that way. The header on the front is for DVP or digital video port cameras with either a 2x9 or 2x10 header with the standard DVP header pinout, which is labeled on the silkscreen for reference. There are jumpers on the back of the board that can be cut and soldered depending on whether your camera uses a 1-bit or 8-bit DVP interface. The jumpers default to 1-bit for minimal GPIO count, but not all cameras support 1-bit mode. Note that for XRP users, if you want to use an 8-bit camera, you'll no longer be able to use some of the features like motor 3 and motor 4. To further help minimize GPIO requirements, an I2C GPIO expander is included on the board, the PCA9534. It connects to the control signals of the display, touchscreen driver, and camera. All control signals are enabled by default, so the GPIO expander is really just there for users who need to access the control signals for advanced use cases. The board also includes a microSD card slot on the bottom for increased storage capacity. It uses the same SPI bus as the display to further minimize GPIO requirements. Finally, the board has dimensions of 2 by 2.3 inches. It includes a quick connector for easy expansion with I2C devices, a reset button, and a power indicator LED. Then we have the Red Vision camera board with HM01B0, which is designed for minimal GPIO count. Other DVP or digital video port cameras can require up to 16 GPIO pins, 8 for data, 3 for synchronization, 1 for an external clock, 2 for I2C, and 2 for control signals. However, this board only requires 6 GPIO pins, 1 for data, 3 for synchronization, and 2 for I2C, though you probably already have an I2C bus already, so it's really only 4 GPIO pins. To achieve this low GPIO requirement, the board uses the HM01B0 camera module from Himax. It supports the 1-bit data mode, whereas most other DVP cameras only support 8-bit mode. This board also uses the color version of the sensor, whereas most other boards on the market with the sensor only offer the monochrome version. The sensor outputs a raw Bayer image, meaning it's necessary to de-Bayer or de-mosaic the image, which does increase the compute overhead compared to other cameras. It also doesn't do any color grading, so it has a somewhat green hue to it. The lens also has a fairly strong vignette, so the edges of the image are darker than the center. The sensor has a max resolution of 324 by 324 pixels, but is typically used with a 320 by 240 resolution. It has a pixel size of 3.6 micrometers and an effective focal length of 0.66 millimeters, or about 183.3 pixels, which is helpful to know to estimate the real-world size of things in the camera's field of view, which, by the way, is about 87 degrees in the horizontal and vertical directions and 115 degrees diagonally when using the full resolution. The board includes a 24 megahertz oscillator for the external clock signal required by the camera. If you instead want to provide your own clock signal through the header pin, you can change the jumpers to disable the oscillator. There are three rows of headers on the board, and the bottom two rows use the same pinout as other 2x9 DVP cameras on the market. If you purchase the full kit, headers will be pre-soldered to these bottom two rows. If you instead purchase the camera board by itself, headers are not pre-soldered. That is where the top row comes in. It's a duplicate of the middle row, so you can instead solder headers to the top and bottom rows to split it across the middle of a breadboard. The board has the same 0.9 by 1.4 inch dimensions and two mounting holes as other camera boards to act as a drop-in replacement for those. And finally, it has a power indicator LED. And that is the new Red Vision Kit for XRP. We cannot wait to see what amazing things you do with it. As always, stay safe, be kind, and happy roboting.